Hi, my name's Jonathan Hicks. I'm back at the Dice Cup, and this evening I'm joined by...
Dean.
David.
Paul.
And we've just finished playing Groves, which is a kind of bag builder. You're picking things out of this bag, but it's also like a worker placement game as well. So you have lots of these fairies, which start off originally in your bag, and at the start of each round, you draw three fairies out of your bag. So we've just been counting them at the end. But imagine I had this as my draw here. And then you each taking turns to place these like workers on your realm, and each of these kind of hexagons represents a space. You can see I've already placed a worker on this space here. And you're trying to get various bonuses. So if I place a worker on this space, one of my fairies, I get the stuff at the bottom left. But if I can match the colour, you see it's like a red background here, I also get the stuff there. So because this is a blue fairy, I really want to place it on one with blue. But it's like a worker placement game. You can't place it where there's a fairy already, so I couldn't put this here, even though I'd really like to get the bonus for doing that. So maybe I could use one of my red fairies, and I could put it here. And it's quite a bit of iconography, but it is nicely summarised around the top of each board. So this means I could then get another fairy of my choice. You kind of look at the supply, and oh, maybe I'd like to have a yellow fairy. And I get to stick that in my bag. And then I also get to take two crystals. So there are various types of tiles. So some will get you resources. You see they've got these earth symbols, light symbols, water symbols. You see you've got these different elements. And one big part of the game is you want to buy more of these tiles to add to your realm. So we've just finished again, but there was like a supply of these. So as well as putting workers on here, you could also take one of your workers and put it on this central board. Let me just turn it around so you can see it. If you go at the top here, you get to buy a new one of these groves. So they're worth victory points at the end of the game, which is one reason why you want to get them. You pay the resource cost at the top here to get it, and also you're paying a certain number of crystals, which is why you need the crystals depending on the position it's in when you buy it. And then you just add it to your area, and you can use it in the future. You can also go on this spot, there are some like bonus cards you can get, and so you're trying to draw certain things out of your bag in order to get points that way. But you can also, crucially, by going on this space, I get bits for a portal. So you kind of buy a base to start with, and then you eventually buy the top bit, and you assemble it. Here's a pre-assembled one. And you place it so it faces one neighbor. So either I'd get it facing Paul, or I'd place it facing Dean. And then it lets me send my workers across to, say, Dean's, if I put it on this end. You see Dean's got one set up here. That means he can send workers into my area. And also when you build a portal, you get one of these naughty black fairies. And the black fairies are great because they're wild, so when you stick it on one of the areas, it always triggers the bonus here. But the problem with the black fairy is at the end of the round, usually, you take all your fairies that have been placed on your board and you stick them back in your bag and then you draw again. But the black fairies kind of sit there and block the space. But one thing you can do with them is you can send them through the portal, if you've got one, to someone else's realm. So you get to put them on there, you get to take their action, then it blocks that space for them. You can send normal fairies through here as well. But at the end of the round then, that means Dean, when he collects all the fairies, will get this fairy and it'll get added to his bag. But this one kind of gets blocked. There are white fairies which are a bit rubbish because they don't trigger the kind of bonus abilities. But one benefit of them is you can use the white fairies to remove the black fairies and stick them back in your bag. So you keep placing them, trying to trigger the bonuses, ultimately trying to get points. There are some gold cards you're aiming for, so in this case we were trying to get the most orange spirits in the bag. Gets 2 points at the end. Trying to get as many points from these groves, and sometimes you can get extra points. This action, for instance, lets you cash in some stuff for some points. Once the stack of groves has run out, you count the points, and most points wins. What do we think?
It's got fairly standard elements, a combination of a deck builder and a bit of a worker placement. The portal to other people's realms looks like it should be a major part of the game, but we hardly used it. I'm not quite sure how the game would pan out if you did use it. I have the feeling that if one person used it, they'd run out of fairies quite quickly, whereas if everybody used it, it would be a completely different game. It's a fairly light deck builder stroke, very light worker placement element. I quite liked it. I wouldn't mind playing it again. I'd score it probably about a 7.
Okay. David?
I had a different opinion of the portals to Dean in the fact that I was affected quite badly by the use of a portal, and I couldn't draw white out, so my point generator at the end was blocked, and the point difference between the leader and me, the loser, I came last, was only 6, so it wouldn't have generated me 6 points. There's a few points there that I might have had, so even just that limited use probably pushed me to the bottom of the pile. Other than that, what you said, it's a fine little deck builder and worker placement. Yeah, it's fun.
Paul?
I enjoyed it. Like everybody else has said, it is a simple sort of worker placement bag builder game. And I think there's enough going on that you have to think a little bit more, especially with the introduction of the portals. You were sort of watching everybody else's spaces. The only thing is I sort of set up two portals that I thought were going to be more effective, but I left until the end of the game, so I didn't generate as many points. I intended to get some points from over here and some pieces from over here and some points from over there, and there was too many steps involved there, but there's enough involved that you are looking at each other boards. But I'd definitely play it again. I don't think I'd buy it, but I'd definitely play it if it was offered on the table, and I'd probably give it 6 out of 10.
Okay, David, rating?
Yeah,
you said 7, didn't you?
Yeah, I said 7.
Yeah, I think it's nice. I like bag builders generally, and it works very well. I like the fact you've got the different coloured fairies. And I like the worker placement aspect you're placing on the board, the way you can trigger the bonus. You have to think what colour fairies do you want to when you're acquiring more fairies, because you're buying certain colours of groves. If you're buying red groves, you want to make sure you've got the red fairies to go with it. But if you're competing for the number of red fairies, then they're going to be in short supply. So you need to think about that a little bit. As I've said, I found there isn't much interaction. I've played another game of this where people were building a lot of portals and sending the spirits through, but even then I didn't find it made that much difference. Like, I won this game and pretty much I just focused on my own board and didn't think too much about what other people were doing. But that doesn't bother me. Just be aware it's not as interactive as I think it might come across at first. So it's nice. I'd probably give it a 7 out of 10 myself. All right, thanks for watching. That was
Groves.